The term cold-blooded killer gets used a lot. It's overused in the print and in movies and elsewhere. But I think in this case, it really applies. When Robert Charles Brown was describing his crimes to the cold case squad in Colorado Springs, he gave them minute descriptions of how he dismembered two of his victims with essentially kitchen implements. And it was, I mean, the descriptions sounded for all of the world like a Julia Child cooking class, how to cut up your fryer for tomorrow's dinner. They were completely dispassionate, clinical, and actually apparently quite professional descriptions of how you do it. The title for the book actually comes from one of Brown's ex-wives, all of whom were terrorized at some point or another in their relationships with him. This one said to an interviewer at some point about 5 or 6 years ago that he's the devil's right-hand man, and then she goes on to say, and she won't be happy until the day he is executed, and she'd like to pull the switch herself. And in sorting through everything we knew about Robert Charles Brown, being the devil's right-hand man seemed to fit him most closely. She was right.
Glenn, you are the co-author with Hugh Ainsworth of the true crime classics, The Only Living Witness, and then Ted Bundy, Conversations with a Killer. What is the difference between Robert Brown and Ted Bundy?
Well, you remember, I spent a lot of time with Ted, got to know him quite well. And Ted taught me a great deal about what serial murder is all about. What Ted and Robert Charles Brown share is that they were both itinerant sex killers. That is, they were motivated, deviantly motivated by what they called sex, to go out and find victims and kill them, and then to keep moving on. They also shared an important attribute that you see in almost all of these killers, that is itinerant sex killers, is that they were sociopaths. They had no guilt and no remorse. They were, in both cases, killing machines.
How many people did Ted Bundy kill, and how many people did Robert Brown kill?
Nobody will ever know exactly how many people Ted killed, and I doubt that anybody will ever know how many that Robert Charles Brown killed. And I would add here that probably neither one of them would ever know for certainty, because there were so many of them, and it is easy for these guys sometimes to forget. However, it appears that Ted probably killed right around 30 young women, and Robert Charles Brown may, and I underscore may, have killed 40, high 40s, low 50s. If his claims are all true, then Robert Charles Brown would be, as far as we know, the most prolific serial killer yet discovered in the United States.
What makes Robert Brown different as a killer then? And what was his modus operandi, and how did he escape the justice system for so long?
Well, one of the scariest things about serial murder, especially when it's committed by somebody who is as bright as Robert Charles Brown is and Ted was, is that it's among the simplest crimes to commit and get away with. I often use the analogy, or use the comparison between going into a pharmacy and stealing candy bars, that you are probably more likely to get caught trying to steal candy bars 10 times in a row from a CVS pharmacy than you are killing 10 strange women in 10 strange places on 10 different nights. Because the initial contact between this type of killer and his victim generally is completely innocent or innocent looking. They meet in a bar. She's in some kind of situation where she's alone. She's approachable. These guys are pretty slick. They can talk their way through a lot of things. He lures her out of the bar. He lures her into his car, whatever he does, but he gets her alone. And at that point, there is usually no way to connect him to her. They're complete strangers. He's probably from a different town, a different state. He's not a member of any of the groups that she's part of. He takes her out, kills her, gets rid of her, and drives on. And if he doesn't leave any forensic evidence, who's going to connect him to the crime? Now, compare that to all the surveillance cameras in a pharmacy watching you steal that candy bar. You're going to get caught.